Hello and welcome to this edition of Phi TV. I'm your host, Brad Swanson. We are coming to you from the first day of the 2021 Florida legislative session. I am once again joined by our friend, Doug Wheeler of the Florida Ports Council. Doug, thanks for coming on Phi TV.
Great to be here once again. Thank you for the invitation, Brad.
Hey, look, well, as a former DOT ports lover, it's always fascinating to see what's going on with global trade and how that's affecting Florida. Before we begin, though, tell us a little bit about the Ports Council. What do you guys do?
Yeah, I'll be brief. Look, we're the professional association for Florida's deepwater seaports around the state. They cover the Gulf of Mexico, the Atlantic Ocean, and really what we provide is research and data. Mm-hmm. We provide advocacy, and we provide support in the areas of communication and marketing to be able to help position our ports to grow their global trade.
Yeah, and the state is has huge impacts on those ports. Their funding for their infrastructure and everything that goes on there, just like they do with DOT and roads and everything else.
Yeah, absolutely. We're talking more than 900,000 jobs around the state supported by these maritime activities, which are in excess of $100 million in economic activity every year.
Yeah.
Massive amounts of local and state tax revenues collected from these business activities. So really, we kind of look at our ports as catalyst for commerce.
So let's talk about the COVID pandemic. How has that affected Florida ports, and how do you see them adjusting to those realities?
Yeah, so look, much like many families and businesses around the state, our ports have absolutely felt the critical, very negative financial impacts of the pandemic, as have the businesses doing business on our ports and even the port communities.
Right.
We worked with a maritime economist that showed that through 2020 alone, we're looking at about 169,000 jobs lost and a total economic impact of more than $23 billion. If we see the cruise shut down through June, which I think we will, unfortunately, we'll see a cumulative revenue loss of our ports of more than $340 million. So, you know, it's tough because we're trying to be that support. We're trying to help our economy recover.
Yeah.
We're bringing in the medicines and the fuels that our citizens and our businesses need, while also trying to, you know, maintain that operational state of readiness for when the cruising comes back.
Well, you think about it. In good times, Florida has the top three cruise ports globally. Pandemic hurts that industry, hurts the entire state of Florida.
No question. I mean, when you're the capital of the global cruise industry, when you shut that industry down, you're gonna feel it, and we are feeling it, unfortunately. And so we're working every day to make sure that we can find a path to work with the CDC and our partners in the cruise industry to get back to safe cruising in the state of Florida again.
Well, let's talk about some port bills. What's going on this year in the Florida legislature to help that industry and ultimately help Florida succeed from the ports perspective?
Yeah, so an offspin of the consequences of this pandemic, unfortunately, we've been presented with a bill that seeks to really, it seeks to preempt all state seaport regulations to the state government. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, we cannot support the bill. It has tremendous, far overreaching consequences, mm-hmm. negative consequences. I think if you just look at the fact that our ports have consistently participated in master planning that works with their local comprehensive plans, those would be undermined. Certainly all the work that they do in order to work with the port users on long-term port user agreements, those would certainly be undermined. I think as an overall, what businesses need, particularly during this time, is stability, predictability. And unfortunately, this bill would completely disrupt the current operation system in our ports. And so we're absolutely opposed to it.
Yeah, well, I think as everyone knows, in the transportation space, nobody does more for Florida ports and the advocacy than the Florida Ports Council. So, Phi TV will stay up to date on what you're doing there. And I'm sure you'll be front and center in the legislative process on these issues as you are every year.
Well, it's always good to come talk ports, and next time we're ready to do it again, and hopefully we'll have some better news to share.
Well,
with
hopefully
you.
At next year, being in the legislative session, we'll be cruising, and Florida
Absolutely.
Will be much more back to normal.
I'm looking forward to it.
Doug, thanks for coming on.
Appreciate it.
That's all the time we have for this interview, and for more great interviews like this one, make sure you hit us up on our social media feed, and for now, thanks for tuning in.